very simple. In the else block body, you can able to give if block. Inside a else block body, we kept if block. Syntactically correct, compilation will be success. You will be getting only if block. You won't get else block. This complete selected portion is skipping. Even though this if block is receiving a true, this will not be attempting to execute. Complete selected portion is skipping. You will be getting main begin, if block, main end. Let's compile and run. So please check it out. This time, if block is receiving a false, because of if block is receiving a false, control will go to the else block. It is not executing line number 8. It is executing line number 12. Because of true, it is executing line number 15, then line number 17, then line number 9. Let's compile and run. Inside a else block, whatever if block is there that is receiving a false, if it is a false, come on. It has to look for else block, there is no else block. You will be getting output as a main begin, else end, main end. Check it out, compilation and running. Let us consider, according to my requirement, line number 12 is not required, assume. Line number 16 also not required, assume. This is what the program I am supposed to develop. Inside a else block body, if block with a false, because of the false, it is not going here. It's not executing line number 14. Mom. You will be getting output as a main begin, main end. Please observe, whatever content is there in the else block, the complete content, it is not executing because of if block is receiving a false. Only if block is there in the body of the else block. But unfortunately, it is receiving a false. This content is not executing. This is straightforward. If block is receiving a false, control going to the else block. In the else block, if we get true, you will be getting else if body, then main end. One small observation. If at all else block containing only if block, no more other statements, only if block, then you can represent this as an else if block. Let me show in the next example. Else block containing only if block, then you can develop a else if. This program is one and the same of previous program. Please understand else if. Thank you. You are getting same output as a previous program. If block inside a else block. Else block executing, inside a else block there is a if block with a false. That is why else if body not executing. You will be getting main begin, main end. Check it out in the output. If both are true, most of the people thinking like both the blocks will be executing. This if block is a part of the else block. This if block is a part of the else block. Now else block is not executing, only if block is executing. You will be getting if block. You won't get else if body just because of this is the else body. Else body containing if body. Even though it is a true, it will not be executing. It executes only if block. Check it out while running. Inside a else body, if block is there and also else block is there. In the else body, we kept if else blocks. If block is receiving a true, if block only executing, it is not going to the else block, even though in the else block, if block is receiving a true, it's not going inside the else block. You will be getting just to main begin, if block, main end. Please observe, because of the false, it's going to the else block, else one begin, because of true, else one if body, because of the true, else will not be executing, you'll get else one end, main end. Check it out. Because of if block is receiving a false, going to the else block after SOP. Again, if block is receiving a false, it will go to the else block. It executes else block. Then else one. May end. Check it out. Output. Assume, according to my requirement, line number 12 is not required. Line number 21 also not required. Assume, I don't require line number 12. I don't require line number 21. I wanted only if else block in the body of the else block. Let's see. Developing in the next program. Please check it out. Else block containing only if else. No other statements. Else body containing only if else. Because of false, control going to the else. Because of again false, control going to the else. You are getting else to body. Check it out in the output. So please observe, this time if block is receiving a false, going to the else block. In the else block, there is only if else block. If is receiving a true, then else will not be executing. You will be getting main begin, else one if body, then main end. Check it out. This time, if block is receiving a true. If it is so, the total else block is skipping. You will be getting main begin, if body, main end. Even though in the body of the else block, there is a if block with a true, the total, this complete section skipped. this section is not executed. That is why you will not be getting this content. Check it out in the console. Please observe, for almost three programs, else block containing only if else, no more other. Else block containing only if else, no more other. If else block containing only if else, we can develop in the shorter way. Let me show how we can develop in the shorter way in the next example. So please observe, this complete selected content, it is in the part of the else body. Come on. Line number 10, else is starting in the else body if else. In the else body if else. If else body containing only if else, then you can develop else if then else. Else if then else. It is one and the same of previous program. Just to compile and run. So because of if block is receiving a true, it won't go to the else block at all. This complete content is skipping. This complete content is skipping. You will be getting main begin, if block, main end. So if block is receiving a false, going to the else block, in the else block again if else is there. If block is receiving a false, you will be getting else to body, else to body. So please observe, single statement, opening brace and closing brace doesn't require. Single statement, opening brace and closing brace doesn't require. If block, then else if block, then else block. See, you can check in the output. So please observe, if block containing else block, that else block containing if else block, that else block again containing if block. Because of the false control going to the else, because of the false control going to the else, this complete else is executing. Complete else is executing. It's almost like a three levels nesting. If else, if block, else block. Inside a else block, again if block. In the body of the else block, there is only if block. First, if block is receiving a false, it will go to the else block. In the else block, again if block is receiving a false, it will go to the else block. In the else block, else to begin. Else to if body, else to end, then else one end, main end. Let's see compilation and run. Same program. Let us see what are the ways of reducing. Assume, according to my requirement, line number 12 and line number 26 both are not required. Assume, according to my requirement, line number 12, line number 26 not required. I required only if else block in the body of the else block. Only if else block in the body of the else block. Let us develop. So please observe, else block containing only if else block. Only if else block. No more other statements. You can just compile and run. This program can be reduced. Let us see how we can reduce this program. So please observe, this complete selected one is a part of the else. Whatever I selected, it is a part of the else. Else containing if then else is complete content. So because of if block is receiving a false, it is going inside a else body. In the else body, if else is there. If is receiving a false, going to the else. Going to the else. Executing. You will be getting same output like earlier. According to my requirement, assume I don't require line number 16 and line number 21. Line number 16 and line number 21, assume I don't require. Let us see how we can develop. Let's compile and run. How we can shorten this? Else block containing only if block. Else block containing only if block. You can make this as a else if. Come on. You can see the shortest way. You can make it as a else if. So please observe, in the else body, this is the content. In this else body, this is the if block. Else if is nothing but inside a else if block. Come on. Else if is nothing but if inside a else. If inside a else. Let's compile and run. If we develop a program like this, guys, else block containing if else, come on. Whatever I selected, it is a part of the else statement, whatever starting at line number 14. This complete selected content going inside a else, whichever starting at line number 14. Come to the line number 10. This line number 10 else containing this complete selected one. Yes or no? So any graduate brain can understand. It's not a first program. We have seen series of the programs by changing statement by statement. Even though three blocks are receiving a true. First if is receiving a true, second and third. Come on, this else block will not be executing because of if is receiving a true. Because of if is receiving a true, else won't execute. In the else body, this complete content is there. Whatever content I selected, completely it is available in the else block. I already told, if first rule is passing, doesn't require to check whether second is passing or not. Doesn't require to check whether third is passing or not. As first is passing, else completely skipping in the else body only. All these are available. So you will be getting main begin, if block, main end. all three conditions are failing here. Because of first condition failing, it's going to the else block. Else block containing this much content. In this content, again rule is failing, it's going to the else block. This else block containing this much content. In the body of this also, if block is receiving a false, it's going to the else. You will be getting else.